वेलकम एवरीवन, दिस इज चिन्मय परीडा, प्राइमरी टीचर ऑफ केंद्रीय विद्यालय गुमला। दिस वीडियो डील्स विद रिसाइटेशन एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन अलोंग विद न्यू वर्ड इलस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द पोएम द लेजी फ्रॉग फ्रॉम यूनिट 5 ऑफ क्लास 5 इंग्लिश। लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द पोएम। बिफोर वी रिसाइट द पोएम, लेट्स मीट फ्रेड द लेजी फ्रॉग, द मेन कैरेक्टर ऑफ द पोएम that doesn't do anything all day long. It tells us about what a lazy person does all day. The poem manages to give it a humorous tone through the frog's behavior. Let's recite the poem and enjoy it.
Fred is a very lazy frog who lolls all day upon a log. Fred is a very lazy frog who lolls all day upon a log. He always manages to shirk doing a single stroke of work. He always manages to shirk doing a single stroke of work, doing a single stroke of work. His poor old mother calls in vain, come in and help, he doesn't bother. His poor old mother calls in vain, come in and help, he doesn't bother. To move 2 inches must preferring to be extremely hard of hearing. To move 2 inches must preferring to be extremely hard of hearing. He lies there in a silent heap and stays conveniently asleep. He lies there in a silent heap and stays conveniently asleep. If a lady frog hops past, you'd think he would get up at last. If a lady frog hops past, you'd think he would get up at last. You'd think he would get up at last. To bow and help her on her way, but no, I am ashamed to say. To bow and help her on her way, but no, I am ashamed to say that when a lady frog comes by, he doesn't open up one eye. That when a lady frog comes by, he doesn't open up one eye. He doesn't open up one eye.
We enjoyed the poem a lot. Now, let's understand the poem. Stanza 1. Fred is a very lazy frog who lolls all day upon a log. He always manages to shirk doing a single stroke of work. It means the poem begins by telling us about a frog who is pretty lazy. The poet has given the frog the name of Fred. We learn about what Fred does all day. Moreover, it shows us how the frog wastes his time without doing anything constructive. Fred is always lolling upon a log throughout the whole day. He doesn't do any work and manages to avoid any responsibility, which may be for him. We learn that Fred doesn't do even a single stroke of work. Stanza 2. His poor old mother calls in vain, come in and help, he doesn't bother. To move 2 inches much preferring to be extremely hard of hearing. He lies there in a silent heap and stays conveniently asleep. It means this behavior of Fred always troubles his mother, the poor mother getting old and wants Fred to help with her work. However, this doesn't seem to bother Fred at all. He doesn't understand his responsibilities and manages to get away with anything. The mother keeps calling Fred to do some work and help her. However, he avoids this, as if it doesn't bother him at all. In fact, he doesn't even move 2 inches from his place. Fred doesn't bother to reply to his poor old mother, as he pretends he doesn't hear her voice when she calls him. In other words, Fred will pretend to be deaf rather than listening to and helping his mother. Fred just remains lying in a silent heap. Stanza 3. If a lady frog hops first, you'd think he would get up at last to bow and help her on her way. But no, I am ashamed to say that when a lady frog comes by, he doesn't open up one eye. It means this lazy frog doesn't move an inch even when a lady frog is passing by him. Generally, even lazy people have something which they get up and do. Similarly, one might think Fred will get up and bow and help the lady frog on her way. But even this doesn't bother Fred. He doesn't even open his eye when the lady frog is passing by. This just proves he is actually a very lazy frog. So, now let's understand what are the new words are there in the poem. The first new word, lol, L-O-L-L, lol. It's a verb and it means to lie around lazily. Here you can see that the cat is lying on the bed lazily. So we can say the cat lolls on the sofa. Next new word is log, L-O-G, log, and it is a noun. It means trunk of a tree that has been cut. See, the person is trying to lift the log, but it's very heavy. So the sentence will be, the log is very heavy to lift. Let's go to the next new word. The next new word is shirk, S-H-I-R-K, shirk. It is a verb and it means not to do something you should do. As you can see in the video, that the man is trying to shirk. The sentence is, the man tried to shirk his duty by pretending to be ill. The man is trying to pretend that he is ill and he shirk his duty. The next word is in vain, I-N-V-A-I-N, in vain, and it is a phrase, it means uselessly. Watch the video. The sentence is, he tried in vain to stop the water flow. Someone tried to stop the water flow by closing the leak, but his efforts went in vain. So the sentence is, he tried in vain to stop the water flow. Now let's go to the next new word. The next new word is prefer, P-R-E-F-E-R, prefer. It's a verb and it means like something better. When we compare two things, if we choose the best, then we will say that XYZ prefer this thing over that thing. Watch the video. It's a video on chocolate ice cream. The sentence framed by me is, someone like vanilla ice cream, but I prefer chocolate. I prefer chocolate ice cream over vanilla ice cream. The next new word, hard of hearing, H-A-R-D-O-F-H-E-A-R-I-N-G. It's an idiom and it means deaf. Watch the video. The boy in the video named Hamid, who is hard of hearing, yelled back, what? Someone is telling him something, but he couldn't listen to that person because he's hard of hearing, he's deaf. So he yells back, what are you saying? I can't hear you. Let's go to the next word. The word is bow. B-O-W, bow. It's a verb and it means to bend your head to show respect. Watch the video. How the two men are bending their head to show respect to each other. But finally, they got an accident. So the sentence is, both are bowing before one another to show respect. But finally, an accident happened.